Hello and welcome to the West Gym atop Burnaby Mountain as we look set up to host the second leg of tonight's doubleheader as we celebrate senior night for the Red Leafs. If you are joining us from the women's game, you'll know that it was one of the games of the year. The Simon Fraser women's basketball team held on to win 68-67 in a thriller just moments ago, and we're sure that the men's team will look to repeat that success. They go into this game 6-22 overall, 4-13 in GNAC. After a run of winning 3 of 4, they have lost their last 4, but all in very, very close games. A double overtime heartbreaker in Alaska, and the other ones with the largest margin being 6-point difference. So a team that really is not represented by their record. For the Vikings, they come into this one 16-22, 8-9 in the GNAC. They need a win tonight to make the GNAC playoffs, and obviously the Red Leafs hoping to spoil that party. They are on a 2-game win streak versus NNU and Central Washington, both games at home where they hold a 10-3 record, but their struggles have really come away from home, away from Bellingham this season. They are only 2-7 when playing away. They are the highest scoring offense in the GNAC, 88.7 points per game they average. But they do average also the worst defense in the conference with allowing 81.5 points per game. The Red Leafs themselves are ranked 9th offensively and 7th defensively out of all 10 teams. Tonight for senior night, our spotlight on number 42, Gio Khan. You'll see him on your screen now. The guard out of Burnaby, BC. He played at Douglas College and then transferred to the University of Fraser Valley before transferring here to attend the School of Business at Beattie. He has played in 5 games here atop Burnaby Mountain, is set to start tonight to make it his 6th. He is a huge leader off the court for this team, and on the court when he's playing a huge part. He's also part of the student advisory committee here at Simon Fraser. A great SFU career as well as the college career at 3 different schools for Gio Khan. He sets to bow out here at the West Gym. Another senior that we are set to highlight tonight, number 3, David Penny. He is a senior out of Guelph, Ontario. He attended Middleburg Academy in Virginia. You're set to see him on the screen right now. He's been averaging 12.5 points per game this season. He's a leader on and off the court. He really leads the side. You see when he's on the court, he controls the tempo of the game. He controls the ball. And he has a career-high 25 against MSUB on February 8th. He's really been on a tear as of late, ending his college career in the perfect way. He is only 19 points away from achieving 1,000 career points at SFU. It is a very achievable goal as he's achieved 19 or more points 5 different times this season. So expect him to get a handle of the ball early and set the pace for the rest one as he chases that 4-digit career scoring record. For Western Washington, the player to highlight, the conference leader with 21.8 points per game. You see him on the screen now. Number 1, Kai Johnson. He's a junior out of Olympia, Washington. He was second team All-GNAC this year. Definitely set to be first team All-GNAC this year as he, again, leads the entire conference with 21.8 points per game. Last time these two teams played in December, he dropped 20 points when Western Washington won in Bellingham 96-74. SFU will look to even out the season score tonight. We are just under 2 minutes away from senior celebrations and player introductions. Stick with us here on Red Leaf TV. Thank you.
Jonathan Nair. And for guard number 20, Nick Well. And center guard number 44, Will Wilson. And coach of the Vikings, Tony McGinnis, with assistant coaches A.J. Overton, Baha Center, and Natalia Jew.
Moments away from tip-off here at the West Gym as the SFU Red Leafs host the Western Washington Vikings in the final game of this GNAC basketball season. The Vikings again hoping for a win today to continue their season in the playoffs next week. Red Leafs hoping to spoil that party, so a celebration here in the West Gym for senior night. Over 750 fans in attendance. Over 150 of you watching online. It's sure to be a great game here at the West Gym as the team's checking out the basketball, making sure everybody's okay with it. Seems to be an issue with it. Haven't seen that one before, but we are set to tip off in the end here. It'll be Sasha Vujicic who gets a tip right off the tip, though, is a bucket up and in from Jonathan Ned. So just to start that Western Washington would have wanted right off the tip. The ball goes the way of Jonathan Ned off the hand of Nick Welp. Vujicic has it for the Red Leafs here. Gives it off to David Penny. Again, David Penny 19 points away from 1,000 career points. At SFU, here's Emmanuel Oladele. Senior Gio Can has it back to Oladele for three. Yes! Emmanuel Oladele opens the scoring for the Red Leafs in this one with a three-pointer from deep. And he's going to pick up Kai Johnson, who again leads the conference in scoring. Three-pointer for the Vikings will go from Nick Welp there. Number 20 opens his account. He's a junior out of Seattle, Washington. Fireworks early in this one. As expected, Western Washington, of course, lead the conference in points per game. There's senior David Penny getting his first bucket of the day on your screen now, number three. So crafty on the ball, so difficult to defend, and leads this team in scoring, leads this team in so many more ways than one, on and off the court. There's a big three-pointer from distance. Won't go. Picked up from Gio Canio. Tip it towards Emmanuel Oladele, who pushes the pace forward. 5-5 ball game in these opening 2 minutes. Oladele has it. Gio Can. David Penny has it. He plays it inside to Oladele. Gets the bump off of Welp. Back to Penny. Defended by Sane. Penny tucks inside. Towards the paint. Ball will roll off. It'll go off of Penny's knee and be Viking basketball. See here on your Red Leaf TV replay. Good defense from Sane there as he made it very difficult for David Penny to get a shot up over Nick Welp. Here is Kai Johnson. Baseline is Wilson. Now all the way across to Welp. Defended by Khan. He'll find Johnson for three. Yes. Connects Kai Johnson and gets a good look. He's going to hit those all night long. One of the most efficient and best scorers in the conference. Someone that the Red Leafs will definitely have to keep an eye on all game long. Here's someone that the Vikings will have to keep an eye on all game long, which was Eric Beckett. His layup won't go, but the rebound will fall to Oladele. Penny. Mismatch against Wilson, and he'll give it off to Beckett. Passes up the three-point opportunity. 8 seconds on the shot clock. He gives it to David Penny. 4-3. Off the back of the rim. It'll be picked up by Ned. Taking it up now is Sane. Western Washington holding on to a three-point lead here to start this game off. Open look for Wilson from three. Off the front of the rim, picked up by Vujicic. Oladele will take it forward here for the Red Leafs. Penny, Vujicic, gives it back off to David Penny. Now Eric Beckett. Beckett takes the jump shot off the back of the rim. It will be picked up again by Ned, and taking it forward now is Kai Johnson. Picked up by Oladele. Gets past number 11, cuts it back. Great pass from Johnson. Right into the path of Nick Welp, who gets the easy lay in. They tried to double there Kai Johnson, and he knew exactly what to pull. Just drawing in the defense and finding the open man, and he does a great job of that. Western Washington take a 5-point lead here. Here is David Penny. Eric Beckett looking for the wide open look. He gets the jumper and he gets it to go. Eric Beckett opens his scoring account for the day with a jump shot. To John Sane. Will Wilson, defended by Gio Khan. Now Jonathan Ned, his jumper won't go, picked up by David Penny. Going the other way now for the Red Leafs. Driving, good layup, tough shot over two defenders. Picked up by Vujicic on the rebound. Has a wide open look from the corner. 4-3, will go for David Penny. And he points out Emmanuel Oladele on that one. A good find from E-Man. The number three, David Penny, he's got 5 points in these opening 5 minutes. Again, just 14 points now away from 1,000 points in his SFU career. It's a great move towards the paint and a layup finger roll from Jonathan Ned. Ned, a senior out of Brentwood, California. He's a transfer from the University of Georgia. Good find from Penny into Vujicic. He'll bump into number one, Kai Johnson, who will get the call. And a great piece of play from the Vikings defensively as head coach Steve Hansen takes his first timeout of the game. Vikings go into this first timeout with a 12-10 lead. We're going to take a break here on this timeout, but stick with us here. Two-point game here at the West Gym between the Red Leafs and the Vikings. Johnson has three. Emmanuel Oladele with 3 points of his own. Eric Beckett with two. Vikings hold on to this 2-point lead after 5 minutes of play in the first half. Both teams looking to spoil Another team's party for Vikings. They're looking to spoil senior night for the Red Leafs. A win would deny the Vikings a spot in the postseason, and these rivalry games are definitely going to have that postseason integrity about it. There's going to be a lot of chippiness between these two sides. A rivalry that runs deep historically. Here's a three-pointer from Ned from downtown off the side of the rim. Penny saved by Johnson right into the path of Beckett. Now Oladele looks up the three. We'll take the three and we'll connect from three. Emmanuel Oladele, 2 for 2 from three-point land. He gives the Red Leafs their first lead of the game, 13-12. We are set for a great game of GNAC basketball in this one. Here's a three from Johnson to respond. Yes! Kai Johnson from way beyond the arc, connecting to make it 2 for 2 for himself. Gives Vikings that two-point lead once again. Here's Vujicic. David Penny up against Sane and gets it to go. David Penny up to 7 points on the day. 12 to go until you see those 1,000-point graphics going up. Now he's defending Sane, Tijon Sane. Ned. Jonathan Ned lays it off for Wilson. Into the game is Elliot Demaculang, and he's going to pick up Kai Johnson here. Johnson step back three. No travel call on that one. He gives it off to Tijon Sane. His jumper looking to bank it home won't go. Now Penny takes it forward, finds Demaculang. Elliot driving on Johnson. He'll lay it off for Oladele, and somehow not a foul called. Going forward here is Ned. Dunks it home. You'll give the Vikings a two-point lead once again. Able to control the tempo of the game is Western Washington. Elliot Demaculang looking to bring it back the Red Leafs' way. Here's David Penny. He'll take that jumper. Contested. Won't go. Off the front of the rim goes to Johnson. Johnson has it. Defended by Oladele. Looking to bring it back. Controls his handle. Good defending from Oladele. Here's Wilson for three. Yes! Will Wilson connecting from three-point land, the junior out of Lorton, Virginia. JUCO product out of Mount Hood Community College. Here's Oladele. Has it. Turn, spin move, takes it off the leg of Nick Welp, and it'll be a kicking foul called. Checking into the game now is number 23, Nigel Hilton, and number 5, Matisse Van Bylant for the Red Leafs. For Western Washington, coming onto the court, number 24, Isaac Morrow, the senior out of Lakewood, Washington. Inbound goes to David Penny. Penny takes the jump shot, contested. Well, it doesn't matter. Contest him all you want. David Penny's got 9 points on the game so far. We're only 8 minutes in. Red Leafs hold a three-point advantage. Jonathan Ned on it. Tijon Sane. Defended by Penny. He puts up the three off the front of the rim. It'll be picked up by Elliot Demaculang, and he takes it forward. No-look pass into David Penny, but he's blocked. Sane gets there first. Oladele. Matisse Van Bylant. Now Penny has it again. Penny feeling it. Lays it off for Demaculang. He takes a tough jumper from the stripe. Will go. Elliot Demaculang. 5-point lead for the Red Leafs. Sorry. Cuts the Western Washington lead to one. It's a 1-point game here in the West Gym. Will Wilson has it. Goes towards the baseline. And no help defense from Hilton. A miscommunication there between Hilton and Demaculang. And coaching staff letting him know about it. Western Washington reset their three-point advantage. Oladele off the back of the iron, and that one will come off of Hilton. It'll be a timeout called by the Vikings, and we'll keep it right here. It's the David Penny show so far for the Red Leafs. He's got 10 points in the opening 10 minutes of this game. Again, his career high is 25. He is only 9 points away now. 9 points away from achieving 1,000 career points. for Western Washington, so important to them, is Kai Johnson. And we just see it, the way he has unlimited range from three-point land. He's been extremely effective. He's 2 for 2 from downtown. And he, of course, leads the conference in scoring. Western Washington lead the conference in scoring with 88 points per game. We're set for a high-scoring end-to-end basketball game here at the West Gym. 6 points for Jonathan Ned, 6 points for Kai Johnson, 9 for Penny, and 10 for Oladele, 6 for Oladele, rather. What, Simon Fraser shooting 3 for 5 from downtown, from beyond the arc, for 60%. 4 for 8 for Western Washington, so a high-scoring game. Both teams effective in offense. Set to be a very entertaining one as we close out the season here at the West Gym. Set to inbound the ball here is Jonathan Ned. Kai Johnson will take the ball up the court, the junior out of Olympia, Washington. Defended by Matisse Van Bylen. Wilson up against Penny. He'll play it out to Ned for three. Won't go. Off the side of the rim, David Penny puts it up the court for Demacke Langan. Euro beyond Johnson and lays it up and in. To quote Steve Hansen there, Euro step skills. That is what he said to the Western Washington bench. As that one rolls up and in, the call will go against Hilton the other way in transition. You can see here on your Red Leaf TV replay. See you later. Took a summer trip to Greece with the Euro. Lays it up and in. Elliot Demacke Langan opening his scoring account for the night. It'll be Kai Johnson from the line looking to extend his 6 point for the day, and he does so. Johnson, good both times from the stripe. We'll make this a 3 point ball game in favor of the Vikings as David Penny takes it forward. With the hot hand, the senior passes it on to Van Bylen. Irish Kokie into the game now. Here's Demacke Langan. Elliott, jumper, takes the foul and the contact, and the jump shot won't go, but he'll be 2 at the line for number 20. The junior out of Mississauga, Ontario. Toronto Basketball Academy product. Here in the West Gym, he does so well of leading the Red Leafs offensively, and he loves those jumpers from in and around the stripe. So tough to defend for the Vikings. He's got an opportunity here from the stripe, which he does do extremely well. He's good both times. From the stripe, it will be Kai Johnson taking the ball up the court here for the Vikings. Defended by Van Bylen. Passes it on for Wilson. Eyeing up the three, will switch it out to Ned. His three contested by Hilton, and they're going to call the foul against Nigel Hilton there. Unlucky call against the sophomore out of Toronto, Ontario. That will put Jonathan Ned at the line. You can see here on the replay, Nigel Hilton, hand in the face, but got in the landing zone of senior Jonathan Ned and gives him 3 opportunities from the stripe here. Ned's first attempt is good, and the second attempt here, oh so good, will make it a 2-possession ball game with 4-point difference between the two sides. Ned good from all three. and he'll take a seat as Western Washington take a 5-point lead. That match is the biggest lead so far of the game, which was also 5 points taken by the Vikings. Here's Matisse Van Bylen, gives it off to David Penny. Irish Kokia has it, eyeing up the three, takes the three off the side of the rim. Rebound picked up, number 25, Louis Grant Holiday. He's a redshirt freshman out of London, England, a transfer out of Seattle U, a D1 transfer. Isaac Murrow has it. Will Wilson. Boxed up by Kokian. I guess the call is going to go against Irish there. See here on the Red Leaf TV replay, he was doubled between Demakulangan and Kokia, and I believe the call will go against number two, Irish Kokia there. It'll be an inbound from Louis Grant Holiday. Inbounded to Kai Johnson, defended by Matisse Van Bylen. He'll go baseline, jump shot, tough bucket. For number one, Kai Johnson, showing off a little bit here in the West Gym, a fadeaway off the right-hand side. Nothing but net. He ups his points tally, and now Matisse Van Bylen. That call will go against Van Bylen. A great piece of defensive play from Kai Johnson, taking the charge there off of SFU's number five. We'll see on the replay here. I don't know if his feet were set. Coaching staff disagree with that one. Head coach Steve Hansen letting him know he disagrees with the call in the most respectful way possible. It'll be a 7-point lead for the Vikings here as they take the ball up the court. Grant Holiday, defended by Penny. Now Vujicic gives it off. Welp, picked up by Van Bylen. He's going to switch it out to Kai Johnson. Wide open look for three off the back of the rim. Picked up by Morrow. It'll fall to Welp, and he lays it up and in. Vikings extend their lead to 9, the biggest lead so far of the night. Here's Demakulangan. Vujicic facing up Welp now. Demakulangan taking it baseline and turns over the ball to Grant Holiday. Going forward here are the Vikings. Loose ball, and it'll go off the foot of Kai Johnson. It'll be a inbound opportunity for the Red Leafs here. Well defended by Matisse Van Bonnen, who will take a seat for number two, Irish Kokia, as well as Elliot Demakulangan, who makes way for Emmanuel Oladele. Kokia takes it forward for the Red Leafs. Alongside him is on the ball now Eric Beckett and David Penny. Back to Kokia. Loses his handle, picks it up by the baseline, finds David Penny against Isaac Morrow. Now Kokia looking to eye up the three, passes it up. David Penny for three. Good, David Penny. 12 points on the night for the senior. He's got the hot hand so far. 2 for 3 from beyond the arc. Here's Kai Johnson looking to respond for the Vikings. Will Wilson eyeing up the three. Step back three over Kokia off the front of the rim. Loose ball, still loose. Picked up by Kokia. Going forward now is David Penny. Penny's layup blocked. And then a hard foul. A tough fall between Beckett and Morrow. See the ball just tipped by Kai Johnson. And then both players going for the rebound, Beckett and Morrow. And a hard fall between the two of them. Foul will be called against Isaac Morrow. Be Red Leaf basketball as we go into this timeout. We'll take a break here as well. Stick with us though, Red Leaf TV. 6-point difference in this one so far. back with 7 minutes of action left in this first half. David Penny, 12 points in this one so far. 5-for-10 shooting, 2-for-3 from beyond the arc. He is 7 points away from that 1,000-point career. SFU shooting the ball well, 50% from the field, 57% from beyond the arc. For Western Washington, 36% from beyond the arc. Oladele looking to inbound the ball. He'll find David Penny. Penny defended by Grant Holiday. Fake pass finds Oladele. Irish Kokia now. Defended by Sane. Now Beckett. 8 on the clock. He puts up the jumper. Won't go off the back of the iron. It'll be picked up by Welp. Now Sane going forward. Tijon Sane. Sane still has it. Goes towards the baseline and he puts in the layup. Up over Sasha Vujicic. He extends the lead for the Vikings. Back up to 8. Penny now with Vujicic. Back to David Penny. Puts up the contested three-pointer. Gets it in. 1! David Penny on fire on senior night. See here on your Red Leaf TV replay. Passes the ball off. Gets it back. And puts up the most contested of three-pointers that you might ever see. Two players in his face. He doesn't care. Rattles it home. And has the opportunity to make it a 4-point play here from the line. Great look from David Penny there as he makes it just a 4-point game after that 4-point play. That brings him up to 16 points. Again, just 3 points away from 1,000. Will Wilson driving inside, defended by George Lefebvre. The last touch will come off of SFU's number 34. It will be Western Washington basketball. Inbounded towards Jonathan Ned, defended by Beckett. He'll take up the jumper, and that's a tough bucket for Jonathan Ned. Gets it to go. Here's David Penny. A 3 would make it 1,000. Kokia. Here's Irish Kokia. He plays into David Penny. Eyeing up that 3-pointer that would make history for him. Penny gives it off to Beckett. Now Oladele has the 3. Gets beyond the defender. Now takes the long 2. The jumper off the front of the iron won't go. Picked up by Lefebvre on the rebound. And 1 for George Lefebvre. And he's letting him know about it. The junior out of Quebec. The University of Vermont transfer making his presence felt in and around the paint. Picks up the offensive rebound, gets the and 1, has the opportunity from the line. And he gets it to go, nothing but net. 3 points for George Lefebvre there. And now bring the Red Leafs within 3 points of the Vikings. 5 minutes to go in this first half. We're in for a fantastic game of basketball here. To John Sane, lays it off. Welp, 4-3, off to the front of the iron, and it'll be Red Leaf basketball off the inbound. Vikings look like they're going to employ a full-court press. To John Sane, calling his team up the court. Press was just on Kokia. They'll let Penny take it up. Now Beckett, defended by Colley. George Lefebvre gives it up for Penny. Penny has it off the pick and roll, finds an open Beckett, defended by Colley, who does well to close him out. Beckett will take the tough jumper and bury it. Eric Beckett, great bucket to put SFU within 1 point of the Vikings here. It's to Don Chain. Looking to change the fortune. He takes it inside, blocked by Lefebvre. Going forward here is David Penny, supported by Lefebvre. Behind the back, his shot, no good. David Penny's shot, also no good, but I believe the foul will be called against Ned on Lefebvre. Yes, a shooting foul called against Jonathan Ned, as you see to John Sane going into the paint, rejected by Lefebvre, who goes up the court and draws the foul. He'll have 2 opportunities from the line here.
E-man one. Benny.
Lefebvre good from his first attempt. This to give the Red Leafs the lead again. Isaac Morrow will check in for the Vikings here as Nick Welp takes a seat. Morrow, a senior out of Lakewood, Washington, transfer from Concordia, Portland. Lefebvre, good both times from the line. 5 points on the day for number 34 as the Red Leafs take the lead 36-35. Under 5 minutes remaining, here's Kai Johnson. Defended by Oladele. Switched on to Beckett. Passes it up. And stolen away from Koki. A great steal off the hands of Grant Holliday. Koki will give it to Beckett. Irish Koki has it again. Red Leaf taking control of the game here. Now Penny. Koki has it. Beckett. Looking to post up Kai Johnson. He's going to take the contested shot blocked from behind Grant Holliday to John Saint. Passes up the open three. Was looking to give it back to Johnson. Now it's Colley. BJ Colley driving on Lefebvre. Gets into the paint and gets the layup to go. BJ Colley with the sophomore out of Everett, Washington with a strong bucket there. Here's David Penny for 1,000 off the front of the iron. The rebound will fall to Kai Johnson. Defended by Oladele, Grant Holliday, BJ Colley. Blocked away, rebound picked up by Morrow. Kai Johnson has it with 10 on the clock. 7 for Kai Johnson to make his move. He passes on away from Oladele. The foul will be called there against BJ Colley as he goes up for the lay. Great charge taken from Eric Beckett. You see here on the Red Leaf replay, he gets away from George Lefebvre. But Eric Beckett there to grab the charge, and the Red Leafs go into this timeout down by one with a lot of momentum on their side. We'll keep it right here. With 16 points, David Penny leads all scorers. Jonathan Ned, 11 points for the Vikings. Kai Johnson, 10 as well. 6 points for Emmanuel Oladele, 5 for Elliot Demakulangan. 5 for George Lefebvre, who has a plus-minus of +4. Irish Koki, a plus-minus of +6, so only bettered by Kai Johnson of the Western Washington Vikings, who are doing a great job of making this game as entertaining as it gets. Back-and-forth action between these two rivals. SFU shooting 55% from 3, 5 for 9, one of their best shooting performances of the season, and they saved the best two last. For Western Washington, they're 4 for 12, 33.3%, 51.9 total field goals, 14 for 27. SFU are 13 for 27 from the field. Biggest lead of the day so far was Western Washington with 9. That was with 8.5 minutes on the clock. This game, with just 3 minutes before halftime, a one-point difference between the two sides. And you got to say, number 34, George Lefebvre, has come off the bench and made this game his own. He dropped 5 quick points, but he's been a presence defensively. He picked up a block as well. He's the redshirt junior transfer out of University of Vermont, Cape Fear Academy. Player out of Montreal, Quebec, and really imposing himself on this game. Here's David Penny, again, 3 points away from 1,000. Finds Lefebvre, defended by Colley. He'll give it up to Kokia. Kokia, step back. Looking to put the moves on Colley. He'll give it up to David Penny. Defended by Grant Holliday. Here's long three from Irish Kokia, which won't draw iron. It'll be an inbound opportunity for Western Washington. DeJohn St. will bring it up here for the Vikings. Morrow, blocked off by Beckett and Lefebvre. Lefebvre grabs it, gives it up to Oladele. Defended by Kai Johnson. Emmanuel Dele goes baseline. Into the paint now. His fadeaway is good off the backboard. Emmanuel Adele, a clinic in scoring. He makes it 8 points on the night. Here's to John Singh. BJ Colley, wide open look from three, will connect. BJ Colley restores the Viking lead, 40-38. 2 minutes remaining in this first half. Relief have the ball with David Penny. Oladele gets a spin away from Morrow, and that shot will go. No foul called as he hits the deck, but it ties the game up at 40 apiece. Here is Kai Johnson, defended by Penny. Johnson has it. Good pass into Colley. BJ Colley picked up by Kokia. Now Johnson goes baseline. Tough shot from Johnson off the front of the rim. Will be picked up by Beckett. Now Penny going forward. Tries to behind the back move away from Sane, but it's picked up by Grant Holliday. To John Sane. Kai Johnson grabs the foul off of Irish Kokia. It's like a blocking foul, and Elliot Demaculangan will check into the game as Irish Kokia takes a seat. Be an inbound opportunity for the Vikings with a minute 25 left in this first half. To John Sane. Eyeing up the three, will take it in, give it up to Nick Welp. Johnson for three, high arcing shot, will go. No foul called as goes away with it with a limp. But a big shot from Kai Johnson. He's 3-for-4 from beyond the arc. High arcing shot that just, you knew as soon as it left his hand, that was gonna find nylon there. Here's George Lefebvre from three, off the back of the iron, picked up by Johnson on the rebound. 48 seconds remaining. Kai Johnson with the basketball. 3-point lead for the Vikings. He's defended by Oladele. Passes it up now to Welp. Nick Welp, defended by Lefebvre. To John Sane. Driving inside to the paint. Will pass it up to Jonathan Ned. Defended by Oladele. He'll take a jumper from the stripe off to the front of the iron, and it'll be picked up from Lefebvre. Here going forward is David Penny. 24 seconds on the clock, and the Red Leafs will take a timeout to draw up one final play here with 22 seconds remaining on the clock. Looks like one of those nights here at the West Gym, a packed crowd, over 800 in the West Gym tonight. Lots of you watching on the live stream as well as we celebrate senior night with our men's and women's basketball team in tonight's doubleheader. The women, of course, coming away with a 1-point victory, 68-67, they beat the Western Washington women's basketball team in a thriller. That was against a nationally ranked opponent that the Simon Fraser Red Leafs were able to come away with a huge victory. In this one tonight, hoping for a repeat. Again, SFU looking to even out the season score. They fell to Western Washington at Bellingham earlier in December, where they lost 96-74. They're looking to change that tonight, even out that season score, and get some revenge, celebrate senior night the right way, and spoil the party for the Vikings, who need to win if they're going to make the GNAC playoffs next week. Penny will inbound it. He'll play it into Elliot Demaculangan. 22 seconds on the clock. Finds Beckett. SFU going for the bucket now, it seems. Here's David Penny. 4-3, contested off the front of the rim. It'll go to Will Wilson. 9 seconds on the clock for Western Washington to get a shot up. They do with Wilson here, defended by Penny. Three on the clock. Wilson spins. Layup, good. Tough bucket. Will Wilson to end the half. The junior out of Lorden, Virginia. Spinning away from David Penny. All three Red Leaf defenders collapse on him, and he's able to spin away from George Lefebvre. Lay it up and in. Gives Western Washington a 5-point lead going into halftime here. 15 minutes away from what is due to be an exciting final 20 minutes here at the West Gym for GNAC basketball season. Stick with us here on Red Leaf TV. Hello and welcome back as we get ready for the final 20 minutes of GNAC basketball action here at the West Gym. We are about 3 minutes away from tip-off here for the second half. Western Washington, of course, hold the lead 45-40. A close one here with eight different lead changes. Five times that the team's been tied. The biggest lead was nine from Western Washington, and both teams have gone on a seven-point scoring run. So very even both sides. David Penny, 16 points. He's 6 for 13 from the field. Again, just 3 points away from achieving 1,000 SFU career points. Emmanuel Odeli has 10 points of his own. He's 4 for 7, 2 for 2 from downtown. He's had a great game so far. And George Lefebvre off the bench making his presence known. He is 5 points with a block as well. He's been huge in and around the paint for Western Washington. Jonathan Ned, 11 points. He's 4 from 8 from the field. And Kai Johnson, 4 for 6 from the field, 3 for 4 from downtown. He's got 13 points and the highest plus minus out of every player with 9. Western Washington shooting 6 for 14 from 3, 42%. The Red Leafs bettering them, though, 5 for 12. And both teams really shooting the lights out in what's been a huge offensive performance. Again, we expected this from Western Washington as they lead the conference in points per game, 88.4 points per game, Western Washington. Nobody scores more than them per average, but also nobody concedes like them, as they also have the worst defensive record in the conference. So a scoreline that was almost expected, and the players that we highlighted before the game, David Penny, Kai Johnson, really leading their teams here in scoring and defensively as well. Just about 1 minute to go here from tip-off, and gotta say, Western Washington, what we expected from them, lots of three-pointers and able to connect at a high frequency. This is a team that does very well, especially in and around the paint. They have 18 points from the paint in this one so far. SFU 16 with Sasha Vujicic making his first start of the season. George Lefebvre coming on for him and also doing a great job in and around the paint. We are just about 30 seconds to go here from the final 20 minutes at the West Gym for GNAC basketball season on Red Leaf TV. As the horn goes, the teams are ready to go. David Penny will inbound this one. Again, 1 3-pointer away from 1,000. From history for David Penny. He's going to play this one in for Eric Beckett. He'll grab it right back off of him. And defended by Dejon Sain. Now Elliot Demakulangan, baseline. Plays Sasha Vujicic inside. Blocked by Jonathan Ned. Going forward now, Kai Johnson. Jump shot off the baseline. Good from Kai Johnson. Big shot from number one. 15 points on the day so far for the GNAC's top leading scorer, Eric Beckett. With it for the Red Leafs now, David Penny. Penny driving towards the hoop. His lane will go. David Penny, 18 points on the night. Just one away from history for SFU's number three. He brings the Red Leafs back within five. Kai Johnson has it, defended by Demakulangan. Top of the arc, he's going to find Nick Welp. Welp gets beyond Vujicic. He'll draw the foul off of Sasha, and it'll be, I believe, just a blocking foul. Or a holding foul, sorry. Picking it up now is Wilson. He'll drive into the paint, and that's a good layup beyond two defenders. Will Wilson grabs his 9th point of the game. He's been so tough to defend. Listed at 6'4", 215. He's very, very tough. Has a really good handle on the basketball as well. The junior out of Lorden, Virginia. Here's David Penny. 4,000. Won't go. Picked up by Vujicic on the rebound. He gives it up to Penny, and he'll take a touch off of Sain. See here on the Red Leaf TV replay. Vujicic just so well to get that rebound off the ground. Gives it up to Penny, who will be able to inbound it now. Just a issue with the game clock here, as needing to fix that one. 7 seconds on the shot clock here for the Red Leafs. They'll play it into David Penny. One bucket away from 1,000. David Penny baseline, goes for the lay, and it's good! David Penny, 1,000 career points for SFU. History made in the West Jam on senior night. David Penny gets his 20th, and he's hearing it from the crowd. What a reception for number 3. Standing ovation from everyone in the building. You can see the reception here in the West Gym. What a moment for the senior, David Penny. 1,001 career points in a Red Leaf jersey. What a moment for the senior out of Guelph, Ontario. Able to achieve 19 or more points for the 6th time this season. What an achievement. Kai Johnson going up, and he's going to get a hard foul off of Sasha Vujicic there. See here a replay of the historic moment in the career of David Penny. Delay up and in off the backboard. He knew it right away. He made history in a Red Leaf jersey. A great moment here in the West Jam, able to celebrate alongside his family and friends. Here's Demacki Langan. Goes baseline, reverse lay, will go, gets the shooter's bounce, cuts the lead down to 3. SFU coming out the gates in this second half perfectly, just the way they would have wanted. Here's Kai Johnson, looking to put an end to that. Defended by Oladeli, goes baseline, picked up by Vujicic, his pass, and a hard foul there. Hard collision between, believe that's Wilson and Demacki Langan, who went down really hard on the deck. He's slow to get up, Elliot Demacki Langan. See here on the replay as Asher Kai Johnson. Yeah, it was an elbow off of Wilson that caught the face of Demacki Langan, who went down hard, and he's going to have to be checked out here by the trainer. Coming in for him will be Irish Kokia. Yeah, just a collision there, and it'll go the way of the Red Leafs. They'll have the ball here. Demacki Langan assuring head coach Steve Hansen and trainer that he is okay to check back in. He will be checking back in soon. On the ball now, David Penny. Lays it off for Oladeli, driving on Wilson. Oladeli spin move, gets the and one. Emmanuel Oladeli. Tough bucket for number 11. He gets his 12th point of the game. He's able to get his 13th from the line as he puts a spin move on Wilson. Grabs the foul off of Welp, and that'll bring the teams to a timeout. 48-49 in favor of the Vikings, but a chance from the line for Oladele, and celebrations on the sideline for the Red Leafs as David Penny achieves his goal of 1,000 points in a Red Leaf jersey. David Penny up to 20 points. Kai Johnson, 15. Jonathan Edd, 11. 9 points for Will Wilson. 12 for Emmanuel Oladele, though. And a high-scoring game. Numbers going either way. SFU yet to shoot a 3 in this second half. Both teams yet to shoot a 3 in the second half. They've both been in and around the basket. 4 for 6 for the Red Leafs. 2 for 3 for Western Washington. Red Leafs lead the second half 8-4. Have another opportunity from the line here with Emmanuel Oladele, who is close to getting his 13th. He has, it's Irish Kokia who has the best plus minus on the court right now. He has a plus 9. He's been very effective off the bench, Irish Kokia. Despite yet to put up a basket of his own, he's really supporting the team defensively. Ali Demacki Langan will check in for him, though, and alongside David Penny, Eric Beckett, Sasha Vujicic, and Emmanuel Oladele, who again is at the line. Oladele, the sophomore out of Niagara Falls, Ontario. just rolls off the rim, and then the rebound will go the way of the Vikings. Taking the ball up the court will be Tijon Sain. Picked up by David Penny. Tijon going right. Penny takes a fall, no foul called. Picked up by DeMacky Langan. They'll roll out to Ned. Johnson behind the back pass to Ned. Open look for Welp from three. Perfect. Western Washington putting on a clinic in basketball there. Behind the back from Kai Johnson into Jonathan Ned. And he found the open look from Nick Welp. Here's DeMacky Langan. Can he respond with a three of his own? He can! DeMacky Langan. Trading threes with Western Washington. Here's Nick Welp going the other way. Transition basketball at the West Gym. 1 point game. What more could you want on senior night? Nick Welp. To John Sain. To Will Wilson. Finds Welp, looking for the reverse lay. He'll get the foul off of Sasha Vujicic, and that will bring Welp to the line. Ready to check into the game now, number 34, George Lefebvre, who did so well in that first half of play. Achieving 5 points, big block defensively as well. Someone who really tough to beat in and around the paint. Nick Welp there, good from the stripe both times. He'll take a seat. Coming in for him is Isaac Morrow. Vikings restore that 3 point lead. David Penny has it for the Red Leafs to take it up the court. 16 minutes remain of SFU basketball at the West Gym for the 2023-2024 season. Oladele has it, puts up the three off the front of the rim. Can't be connected with Lefebvre on the rebound. Here's Kai Johnson going the other way here for the Vikings. Tijon Sain passes up the three, takes a long two. No, he plays it off for Wilson. Looking for the and one, doesn't get it, but the bucket goes for Will Wilson. 5 point lead for the Vikings. David Penny looking to cut into that lead. Lefebvre, Penny. Beckett, defended by Ned. Now Morrow switches onto him as he gives it up for Penny. ISO against Johnson. Lefebvre will put the screen. Pick and roll into Lefebvre, going to the paint. Elliot DeMacky Langan, first time around, can't get it. Second time, connects with the rebound and the putback to bring it back to within three for the Red Leafs. Here is Kai Johnson going the other way. Baseline, defended by Oladele. Johnson. Sorry, Ned for three, connects, Ned. Jonathan Ned, 14th point of the game. He is perfect. Sorry, he is 1 for 3 from 3 point land. He is perfect from the stripe. Here's David Penny. Going forward, he'll find DeMacky Langan. Pick and roll with Lefebvre. He's gonna play it out to David Penny at the top of the arc. Now Lefebvre has it. Backing up Morrow, gets into the paint, gets it beyond Ned, and he gets it to go. George Lefebvre, tough bucket, 7th point of the game for number 34. Vikings will take it forward with Morrow. Wilson eyeing up the three. Passes it on to Sain. Defended by Penny, Sain will drive it off, lay it off, gets it back. Sain for three, connects to John Sain, gets his first three-pointer to go of the day. Great move between him and Wilson to find the open look, and that increases the Viking lead to 7. Beckett has it, and he lays it off for Oladele. Action for Penny. Pick and roll, looking for Lefebvre. Open man is Oladele for three. Yes, Emmanuel Oladele connects once again from downtown. 15 points. He's 3 for 3 from beyond the arc. He's having himself a amazing game. He's got 15 points. I believe his career high is 19, so liable to break the career high tonight. Emmanuel Oladele, the sophomore out of Niagara Falls. Kai Johnson. Touch goes off of DeMacky Langan, and then the call's going to go against Johnson. It'll be Red Leaf basketball. believe a timeout will be called by the Red Leafs. Be great to see on the replay one more time that three-point look from Elliot Demakulangin and Emmanuel Oladele. Just so effective, the Red Leafs from three today. You can see here Elliot passes up the three, gives it to Oladele, and he connects. He's been so good from beyond the arc. The Red Leafs, so good from beyond the arc. They are 6 for 13, shooting over 50% from three. Three players for the Red Leafs, over 10 points. Oladele with 15, Penny 20, Elliot Demakulangin with 12. Elliot is 5 for 6 from the field. Oladele 6 for 10, 3 for 4 from the three. Been having a great game offensively. But for the Vikings, they're spreading their scoring around. 14 for Ned, 12 for Welp, 15 for Johnson, 11 for Wilson. They're shooting 3 for 3 in the second half from beyond the arc. Red Leafs 2 for 3. Game percentage is 7 for 15 from 3 for the Red Leafs. 9 for 17 from 3 for Western Washington. And that's the difference between them now. 4 points split these two sides as Matisse Van Bylen checks into the game to inbound the ball. As 13:33 left in Red Leaf basketball this season. Looking to mount a comeback against the Viking side. Desperate for a win. A win would give them a huge boost in making it to next week's GNAC playoff tournament. Here's the Demakulangin, defended by Morrow. Finds Lefebvre. Elliot Demakulangin passes up the three. Gives it up to Oladele, defended by Wilson. Oladele drives inside, looking to put up the lay, and it goes. Emmanuel Oladele, 17 points on the day. Offensive clinic from the sophomore. Now he's defending Kai Johnson. John Sane looking to go beyond Penny. Blocked away by George Lefebvre. John Sane looking for the floater. Lefebvre rejects it. Ned passes inside for Sane. They'll go to Wilson. Another block by Lefebvre. They'll call this one a foul against 34. Just a shooting foul as Ned went up for it. Fev met him at the rim. Too much of the wrist. It'll give Will Wilson an opportunity from the line here for the Vikings to extend their lead. Wilson can't connect with the first look. Second look for Will Wilson goes, and now we'll make it a three-point game in favor of the Vikings. SFU knocking on the door of victory here. Van Bylen. Demakulangin has it. Gets the screen off Lefebvre, gives it back to Van Bylen. Picked up by Wilson, he plays it into the paint for Lefebvre. The finger roll goes for George Lefebvre. Up to 9 points on the day. The Red Cert Junior off the bench making a huge difference in this one. Picks up Grant Holliday in the paint. Blocked by Lefebvre. Once again, here goes the Red Leafs the other way with David Penny. Cuts inside, his finger roll. Put back from Elliot Demakulangin goes. SFU take the lead 64-63. Vikings push the pace going forward with Ned. His lay-in, no good. Red Leafs have the momentum and the basketball with Demakulangin. Gives it off to Penny. Picked up by John Sane. Penny into the paint. Looking for an outlet pass. He finds Lefebvre. Step away from Kokia. Penny. Foul against to John Sane. Be a holding foul, I believe. You can see here on the Red Leaf replay as Grant Holliday goes inside. George Lefebvre, thank you very much. The redshirt junior out of Quebec. Again, having one of those days. David Penny, his layup doesn't go, but you can see the follow-up. The determination from Elliot Demakulangin one of the best parts of every game day, a half-court shot opportunity from one of the fans. We'll take a break here as this half-court shot goes up and inevitably airballs. But it's a 64-63 game in favor of the Red Leafs. Stick with us here, Red Leaf TV. Just got a text that he hates that I was right about the airballed half-court shot. Sometimes you just know it's coming. Sometimes, like, if I shot that half-court shot, it's also not connecting with anything. It's not a personal attack. It's just facts. Inbounding the ball now is David Penny. Over to Van Bylen. Now Irish Kokia. SFU holding on to this one-point lead. Demacia Langan has it. Now David Penny, picked up by Grant Holliday. Now Colley gets the screen off of Lefebvre. Four on the shot clock for David Penny. Has to work some magic, and magic he almost works off the rim, and Lefebvre can't connect on the rebound. Wilson has it going forward for the Vikings. Into Johnson. Grant Holliday. Ned back to Grant Holliday. Passes up the three for BJ Colley. Baseline taken away from Van Bylen. It will be Viking ball off the inbound. 11 to go in the second half here. Inbounded back to Johnson. Looking to put up a jumper. He'll play the behind the back pass to Wilson, who connects from three. Western Washington again showing how good they are offensively. Right when you think you have them caged up, backwards, no look pass into Will Wilson, who knocks down the open three. That's his 15th point of the game for Will Wilson, number 44. Here's Irish Kokia, top of the arc. Defended by Colley, passes up to Van Bylen by the baseline. Picked up by Colley. He'll play it off to George Lefebvre, and his lay-in is good to go. George Lefebvre up to double digits on the night. 11 points for the big man from Quebec. Great assist, great look from Van Bylen there, getting the bump off of Colley on your replay. You can see it. George Lefebvre, a good movement inside. Grant Holliday, too slow to pick him up. Going forward now is Ned. Picks up with Kai. Kai Johnson, double teamed. Will switch the ball out to Wilson. His three is good. Will Wilson back-to-back threes for the big man. Catching fire at the right time. Western Washington take a three-point lead. Here's David Penny into Lefebvre. David Penny lays it off for Kokia. Three-pointer deep from Demacia Langan off the side of the rim. Saved and picked up from Van Bylen, but he steps out of bounds. It's a good look there for the Red Leafs. Just can't get it to connect. George Lefebvre will take a seat for Sasha Vujicic, as well as Van Bylen and Irish Kokia coming in, as well as Eric Beckett and Emmanuel Oladele. Taking it up the court now is Kai Johnson. Under 10 minutes remaining in this basketball season here for the Red Leafs. They look to go out with a statement victory. But Will Wilson, deep in his bag, can't stop him right now. The man is catching fire. Three consecutive buckets for 44. If you're wondering why I went silent, my life flashed before my eyes. The ball was coming my way. I have a cup of mate. It's like a tea. If it spills, it's not a good look. I was really hoping the ball didn't hit it. Here's Ned for three off the front of the iron. Rebounds loose. It's going to come off of Eric Beckett, and love to see a replay of that one. Elliot Demakulengan asking for the same. You can see here a great look from our cameraman, Jose Castro. Looks like it came off of Beckett or Colley. Colley's going to have the basketball, driving on Vujicic. He loses it. Great defending from Vujicic. Oladele picks it up. Gives it off to Demakulengan. Going forward here are the Red Leafs. And foul will be called, and the referee bench cannot believe it. I would love to see a replay there on the wide angle. You could see Elliot Demakulengan running with the basketball, and Vujicic is called for that. Are we sure? A commentator can't give his opinion, but I'm just going to quote the bench right next to me, assistant coach Noah Abdi. Two incorrect calls in a row, pretty ridiculous. Vujicic picks up the rebound, ball don't lie. Oladele gives it to Demakulengan. 8 minutes on the clock, 5 point difference between the two sides. Penny, back to Oladele. Vujicic gives it to Demakulengan. Finds Beckett, baseline. 7 on the clock, 5, 4. Beckett putting the moves on Wilson. Step back, jump shot. Off the side of the iron, won't go. Ned takes it forward, Wilson. Euro, blocked by Beckett. Going forward is the Red Leafs, and Elliot Demakulengan just wasn't looking for it. What a play from Eric Beckett to stop the momentum of Will Wilson. See here on the Red Leaf TV replay, Euro beyond Oladele, and a fantastic block from Eric Beckett. SFU just can't make them pay in transition, but a 5 point game could still go either way with 7.5 on the clock. Timeout here taken by the Red Leafs. We'll take a timeout ourselves. Stay with us here though, Red Leafs TV. .47 to go in GNAC basketball season here at the West Gym. It's been the Will Wilson show in this second half. He's up to 20 points on the night. 8 for 13 from the field, 3 for 6 from 3. Western Washington are shooting 5 for 7 in the second half from 3-point, man. That's an unbelievable statistic. They are shooting 71% from beyond the arc. And that's the difference between the two sides here. Red Leafs shooting 2 for 4, which is not bad themselves, but it's not 71%. And that 6 point difference in the scoreboard is evident there. Here's Kai Johnson looking to extend it. Defended by Oladele. Ripped away from Johnson, but it'll go into the hands of Colley. Now Wilson with an open look into the basket. Easy lay-in to make it 22 on the night for Will Wilson. Demakulengan gives it to Beckett. Penny. Defended by Colley, steps beyond the two defenders, and a great look from David Penny there as he gets his 22nd point of the game. Cuts the lead back down to 5. Here's Kai Johnson. Wilson gets beyond Demakulengan, will take a long 2 and gets the foul off of Emmanuel Oladele. Will Wilson putting on an attacking clinic as he's able to step beyond Elliot Demakulengan and draw the foul, draw the contact off of Emmanuel Oladele. Give him 2 opportunities at the line here. Wilson connects both times from the stripe, it would be a seven-point ball game. SFU with the basketball looking to cut into that lead. Beckett has it. Now David Penny gets the screen from Vujicic. David Penny with a tough jump shot that rolls in. David Penny on your screen right now, leading scorer for the Red Leafs, 24 on the night for the senior in his final SFU collegiate basketball game. Here is Jonathan Ned, defended by Beckett. Step back, tough jumper, won't go. Picked up from Demacia Langan. Demaculangan has it, connects with Penny, gets the screen off Vujicic. David Penny into the paint now, defended by Cauley. Passes it out for Oladele, defended by Wilson. He takes it baseline, jump shot off the side of the rim, won't go. Picked up from Kai Johnson. He's going to drive straight at Beckett and draw the end one. Tough bucket from Kai Johnson. See here on your Red Leafs TV replay as he takes a step into Beckett to draw the contact and then gets the lay in to go. Gives himself the opportunity to get his 18th point of the game and extend the lead up to 8 for the Vikings if he can connect from the stripe here. It is good, and checking into the game is number 34, George Lefebvre. He checks in for number 14, Sasha Vujicic. Here's Penny. Demacia Langan. Defended by BJ Cauley. Step back on Cauley. Penny has it. Baseline defended by Johnson. He'll pass it up to Beckett. Beckett for three off the side of the rim. And he'll just fall out of bounds. The Vikings basketball. 5.5 minutes remaining here at the West Gym. Red Leafs need a spark. Johnson will give it up to Ned. Wilson has it. His pass inside for Cauley. Missed dunk. We might see that one shacked in the full. And the crowd's letting BJ Cauley know about it. We don't like to show the lowlights here, but a beautiful replay there as BJ Cauley. He had a smile when he was going up for that dunk. There was a smile right across his face, which quickly went away when he just smashed it against the side of the rim. He'll keep it in an 8-point game. Here's David Penny, 4-3 off the front of the rim. Picked up from Grant Holliday. Good rebound from him, and he passes it off to Kai Johnson. Johnson defended by Beckett, gets a screen off Cauley. His jumper passed off to Grant Holliday. Great pass. Grant Holliday's finger roll is good. 10-point lead for the Vikings. It is the biggest lead either side has had all night long with only 4.5 minutes remaining. SFU need to turn this one around, and they need to turn it around fast. Here's Demacia Langan. Drives into the paint, loses the ball. The momentum's all with the Vikings as they go forward with Kai Johnson. His pass into Wilson. Wilson looking for the end one. The foul will go, the bucket won't. But Will Wilson, an opportunity at the line to extend the lead for the Vikings. Head coach Steve Hansen will call a timeout here as Western Washington go on a bit of a scoring run there. They take an 11-point lead, a possible 12-point lead with Will Wilson at the line as we come back from the timeout. All the momentum going the Vikings' way as they are close to securing that playoff place with a win here tonight. As if you need a spark, they need a change in these final 4.5 minutes to give this crowd of 800 at the West Gym something to cheer about. So far it's Will Wilson with 25 points. 18 points for Kai Johnson, 14 for Jonathan Ned, 12 for Nick Welp. For the Red Leafs, 17 for Emmanuel Adele. He is a bucket away from achieving his career high. David Penny has 24 points. Elliot Demacalangan, 14. George Lefebvre, 11. SFU shooting 49% in the game, 41 from three, which is fantastic. 7 for 17, but Western Washington shooting the lights out here at the West Gym. They are 11 for 21 from beyond the arc, 52%, 54% from the field, 29 for 53. In this second half, they are 71% from beyond the arc. They are just shooting the lights out, putting on an offensive clinic, and it's that efficiency right there that really, really makes a difference between these two teams, and that's why we see this 11, possibly 12-point difference in score. Will Wilson at the line able to get his 26th point of the game if he's able to connect from the stripe. Highest plus minus of anybody on the court. He's got plus 14. He really has made the difference today. Here's David Penny. 82-70 ball game. Under 4.5 minutes remaining. SFU need the spark. Could they find it from Irish Koki on the ball now? Play action into Oladele. Back to Kokia. He takes up the three off the side of the rim. Rebound from Lefebvre, picked up from Oladele. Second chance opportunity here for the Red Leafs as David Penny has it. Picked up from Jonathan Ned. Now Kale. Oladele shoots the three off the side of the rim. Western Washington will slow the pace down here. Kai Johnson picked him from Oladele at half court. He'll play it off to Jonathan Ned. Now Will Wilson puts up the three off the front of the rim. Picked up from Oladele on the rebound. SFU pushing the pace now. Oladele has it. Gives it to Beckett. Beckett, wide open look from three. Off the back of the rim. And the rebound falls into the hands of BJ Cauley. Kai Johnson has it. Down to 3.25 remaining. Johnson picked up from by Oladele. Finds BJ Cauley. Now will Jonathan Ned takes a step beyond Lefebvre, and that jumper in the face of Eric Beckett is good. It extends the lead up to 14. This one might be getting out of the hands of the Red Leafs. David Penny gives it up to Beckett. Screened by Lefebvre. Now Penny. Lefebvre. Off the left-hand side, going into the post, defended by Johnson, finds Irish Kokia in the corner, goes baseline, and that ball just gets away from Irish Kokia. It'll be Vikings basketball, 2.5 remaining, 14-point lead, and the Vikings, the offensive clinic in this second half, proving to be the difference in the West Gym as it takes the air out of the crowd. Johnson into Ned, into Wilson. Great pass from Johnson. Looking for BJ Cauley. SFU going the other way now. An open look for Irish Kokia, who will lay it up and in. And that will be a timeout, I believe, called by the Vikings. A fast break point opportunity for the Red Leafs. Cuts this lead down to 12. 2 minutes remaining in the GNAC basketball season here from the West Gym. SFU need a spark, and they need a couple threes to cut this lead down. It's a four-possession ball game. As the teams make their way back onto the court. SFU talk it over, back into the game. Senior Gio Khan for his final 2 minutes in his collegiate basketball career at the West Gym alongside number three, David Penny. Vikings basketball, they play it into Kai Johnson. SFU looking to play the full court press. They're able to pass out of it with DeJohn Saint. Now Will Wilson gives it up to Kai Johnson, defended by Oladele. Western Washington happy to bleed out the clock here. Kai Johnson, double teamed. To John Saint, drives inside, gives it up to Wilson. Passes up to three, 7 on the clock to shoot. To John Saint has it, Gives it up to Grant Holiday. 4-3 connects. Grant Holiday could be the dagger in this one as it gives Western Washington all the momentum they need. A minute 30 remaining. Gio Khan going inside. Foul will be called against the Vikings. See here on the red leaf replay. Gio Khan takes a step inside. That foul called against number 13, Jonathan Ned. Be an inbound opportunity for the Red Leafs. Coming off the court for one final time at the West Gym is number 3, David Penny, to a fantastic reception at the West Gym. A amazing career at SFU, David Penny. Achieving 1,005 points over the course of his career. Took up a huge role as a leader of this program this year and has done a fantastic job leading his team on and off the court. Here's Lefebvre. Gio Khan has it. The bench willing him to shoot. Gio Khan drives into the paint, looking to get the layup to go. Won't go. Be picked up from Jonathan Ned. To John Saint. 15-point game. Just about a minute remaining in this one. Vikings just about all but secured this victory. Don't need results to go their way elsewhere to secure a playoff spot for next week. Here's Kai Johnson. Kai Johnson puts up a tough bucket, and Will Wilson with a circus trick shot to try to get that one to go. It comes off the rim. It'll be Red Leaf basketball with Lefebvre. Drives direct on Grant Holiday. Blocked away from Grant Holiday, and the layup won't go from the redshirt junior of Quebec. The Red Leafs elect to foul to John Saint there. Checking into the game now will be number 22, Tate Christensen. He's a redshirt freshman out of North Vancouver, BC. Coming off the court is number 10, Eric Beckett. To John Saint, we'll have one-on-one at the line. As we come to the final 36 seconds of the GNAC basketball season here. John Saint, good from the first one. Good from both from John Saint. He'll make it an 89-72 ball game with 35 on the clock. Irish Kokia takes it up, gives it off to Emmanuel Oladele. Gio Khan has it. We're going to put the moves on the defender, and he gets the bucket to roll, and the bench is happy about it. Gio Khan gets his points on senior night. And that one will draw this game to a close as DeJohn Saint dribbles this ball out of. That will bring this basketball season to a close. Final score set to be 89 for the Vikings, 74 for the Red Leafs. In what was a fantastic exhibition of offensive basketball at the West Gym, SFU close out this season. They will go to 6-23, 4-14 overall GNAC record. A season in which they definitely made lots of improvements on the prior seasons. Very exciting team to watch in the future. A lot of freshmen and sophomores that will grow over the offseason and come back next fall and continue to improve this program into the right direction. Be right back with some final stats of the match. But a huge performance from Will Wilson of Western Washington, doing a fantastic job for them. Him and Kai Johnson really teaming up to do a great job putting up 89 points, and that will bring this GNAC basketball season to a close. We appreciate everyone watching throughout the season on Red Leaf TV. Wish you a happy off season and a happy summer. Thank you for all for watching. Final score here on Red Leafs TV, 89 for Western Washington, 74 for the Red Leafs.